In this video, you'll see how to build an Apache Spark ETL job using Amazon CodeWhisperer. With CodeWhisperer, you can generate ETL code in Python, create and submit infrastructure resources using the AWS CLI, and verify the results in Amazon Athena. For this demonstration, we'll work in the Amazon EMR serverless environment. To get started, let's launch EMR Studio. We'll name the application we're creating CodeWhisperer because that's the tool we're going to use. We'll keep the type set to Spark and retain the default settings. Let's create the application. Now that we have an EMR serverless application, we need a Spark job to run. Let's open the application. We can click Submit Job to see what we have to prepare. We'll need to provide a runtime role, an Amazon S3 location, and a script here. We'll also want to adjust the application log settings. Let's view our Amazon S3 buckets. For our purposes, we've already created a log folder for the EMR service log. This folder is empty now. Later, we'll upload the input data and a Spark script into this bucket. Let's view the input data we are going to use. We're going to use this sample taxi data. Currently, some of the column names are in uppercase. Our Spark application will change the column names to lowercase and also calculate the total number of columns in this CSV file. Let's use CodeWhisperer to create a Python file. We'll write a comment to tell CodeWhisperer to use PySpark to count the total number of records in the CSV file. We can trigger CodeWhisperer suggestions manually by using the Option C key combination on a Mac or Alt C key combination on Windows. To accept a suggestion, we can press our Tab key. Let's tell CodeWhisperer to create a method to read the CSV file from Amazon S3 and put it in the Spark data frame. We'll accept the code suggested by CodeWhisperer. Next, we'll tell CodeWhisperer to create a method to store the data frame as a CSV file. Next, we'll tell CodeWhisperer to create a method to count the total number of records in the data frame. We'll also tell CodeWhisperer to create a method to print out the schema of the data frame. Next, we'll ask CodeWhisperer to create a method to convert the field name to lowercase. Now that we have all the methods we need, let's tell CodeWhisperer to put them together in order. Let's quickly edit the Python main method. Let's also put our own bucket and key information here. Now let's go back to our Amazon S3 bucket and upload our Python script and sample data. The upload succeeded. The script and data have been added to the bucket. Now let's go back to the Spark job we're going to submit. For the runtime role, let's create a new IAM role. We'll limit the permission for the EMR serverless runtime role to our S3 bucket. Next, we'll point to the script location in our Amazon S3 bucket. Finally, we'll choose to upload our ETL logs to the log folder in our Amazon S3 bucket. Let's submit the job. The job succeeded. Let's view the driver log files. We'll click the standard output. This output shows the total number of records in the input CSV as well as the schema of our data frame. Now let's return to the S3 bucket. We have a new folder called Output. Let's see what's in it. Let's open this CSV file. Observe that all the column names are now in lowercase. You've just seen how to build an Apache Spark ETL job using Amazon CodeWhisperer. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.